Walt is Candid. The central characters are, one is Candid, is a very simple young man who is always out experiencing the world. Then we have Baron of Thunder Ten Tront, who appears to be the vain, pompous, living in a castle at Westphalia. He also has a son and a daughter, and in a way he represents Frederick the Great of Prussia. Then the heroine Cunegonde, the Baron's beautiful daughter with whom Candid is in love. Then we have Dr. Pangloss. Pangloss is a learned philosopher and tutor to the Baron, and he is always spreading the philosophy, or he's an exponent of the philosophy of optimism. Then we have Paquette, a chambermaid in the Baron's household, and she has an affair with Pangloss and infects him with a disease. Then there are many other characters: Anabaptist, the old woman, the Grand Inquisitor, Don Isacher, Don Fernando, Cacambo, Martin, Friar, Giroflee, Senator Procurnet. Okay, all those characters are there, but we needn't bother about them now. At present, we'll come to what is happening in chapter one. So the story begins in Westphalia at the castle of the high and mighty Baron of Thunder Ten Tront. His 350-pound wife, their beautiful young daughter Cunegonde, and an unnamed son. So they are living happily at the castle, and is Candid, whose name points to his character, that of one who is symbol of mind and sound of judgment. So the story is now set in the Baron's castle at Westphalia. Okay, and there we have the Baron, his unnamed son, his Baron's wife, whose weight is 350 pounds, and their daughter Cunegonde. They are living happily in the castle, and they have a philosopher master trainer called Pangloss, and Pangloss is teaching logic to them and all other things. So Pangloss' philosophy is that this world is the best world. There is nothing to dispute that fact, that this is the best world, and whatever happens is for the good, best of all possible worlds. And so we have Candid. Candid has fallen in love with Cunegonde, the daughter of Baron. And so we have Pangloss there, the philosopher, the tutor. So the significant thing that happens in the first chapter is that Pangloss has some, even though he is philosophically rich in content and he is a good teacher and his philosophy is strong, still he falls into having illicit affairs with the chambermaid. And Cunegonde herself witnessed this relationship with great interest, and the incident that took place in the wood on her father's estate makes her very curious about all these things. And so she now engages in what according to Pangloss is experimental physics. So experimental physics, she engages in this experimental physics with our poor Candid, and as a result the Baron catches them both out in the garden enacting the experimental physics. So he gets hold of them, both of them. He found them kissing under a tree, so he gets hold of them, and Cunegonde receives a slap on her face, but poor Candid was kicked out of the castle, and he did not know what to do, so he was thrown out of the castle. And now Cunegonde and Candide, they are separated. So for the act of having an illicit relationship between with the daughter of the baron kicks Candide out of the castle. And now Candide is out of the castle and is going to wander around a lot. So Candide was now thrown out of the palace, and now he is in total misery, and he is freezing. He dragged himself towards a neighboring town, nearly dying from hunger. And at the door of an inn, two uniformed men addressed him, and very strangely they offered to give him, buy him food, because he was 5 feet 5 in height. Men are made to help each other, explained one, and Candide was moved and delighted to hear this confirmation of Dr. Pangloss's teaching. They induced the youth to drink to the health of the Bulgarian army and announced that he was a soldier in the king's army, a hero whose glory and fortune are assured. So now we find that he walks up to an inn, and there two soldiers are there. They immediately help him. They give him food, and they say that men are made to help each other. So that is something really which makes Candide happy, because Dr. Pangloss, whose philosophy is that the world is the best world and the people are all will do good. So this is the best world. So this philosophy that was handed over by his teacher, Dr. Pangloss. You remember Pangloss? Pangloss had an affair with the chambermaid, and because of that, seeing that Cunegonde tries to experiment that with Candide, and they get caught, and that's why Candide is thrown out. ഇപ്പോൾ കാൻഡിഡിനെ പുറത്താക്കിയത് ഈ സംഭവമാണ്. പക്ഷേ ഡോക്ടർ പാൻഗ്ലസിൻ്റെ ഫിലോസഫി ഇപ്പോഴും ഉറച്ചു വിശ്വസിക്കുന്നുണ്ട് കാൻഡിഡ്. ആൻഡ് ഹി ബിലീവ്സ് ദാറ്റ് ഇറ്റ് ഈസ് ബിക്കോസ് ദ വേൾഡ് ഇസ് പെർഫെക്റ്റ്, ദ വേൾഡ് ഇസ് സച്ച് എ ഗുഡ് പ്ലേസ് ദാറ്റ് ഹി ഈസ് ഏബിൾ ടു ഗെറ്റ് ഫുഡ്. സോ ഹി ഈസ് ഹാപ്പി ആൻഡ് ഹി ദേ മേക്ക് ഹിം ഡ്രിങ്ക് ആൻഡ് നൗ ബട്ട് ഈവൻ ദോ ഹി ഈസ് ഗോയിങ് ടു ബി ഹോണർഡ് ബൈ ദ കിങ് ദ ബൾഗേറിയൻ കിങ് ബട്ട് ഹി ഫൈൻഡ്സ് ഹിംസെൽഫ് ഇൻ അയൺസ്. That means bound in irons and taken to the regiment. And he is now recruited to be a member of the Bulgarian army, and he is put through endless drills and nearly beaten to death. One day, finally ran away, but he was caught by the other soldiers and bound up and put him in a dungeon. And he was offered two choices. One was that either to be beaten unmercifully 36 times by the whole regiment rather than to be shot dead. So two choices. One, to be beaten up. That means it is not simple beating. Everybody will beat that man. Everybody in the army will beat the man, and that will be going to be really, really something that is cannot be tolerated. So and the second choice was to be killed. And this punishment is such that anybody will say that it is better to get killed, because you will get killed either way. It is better to be killed at one shot rather than be beaten up and killed. Anyway, so finally the king of Bulgaria himself appears and pardons him, Candide. So after some beating, he is pardoned, and 3 weeks later the youth get restored to good health and is able to join his fellow soldiers in the war against Barbarians. So the war between barbarians and Bulgarians. So he's able to join the Bulgarians to fight against barbarians. So in the third chapter, Voltaire describes the glories of war, the well-drilled troops, the martial music, and the heroic butchery. So this is how he describes war. It is a well-drilled, the troops are well-drilled, so march perfectly. Then the martial music is also good. Then the act of killing people, which he terms as the heroic butchery, is something which is horrible. And Candide hid himself as best as he could. And while both kings are having a big fight, there are many dying in the Iberian village. Poor women, poor children, everybody is killed, and everything is burned, and houses are destroyed. So they are making sure that nobody escapes. Women, children, old men, all get skilled and Khalid now understands about the futility of war, and he runs away to another village, which proved to be a Bulgarian one, and found that it and the inhabitants have received the same treatment. At last, he escaped from the theater of war, and he is now really sad because he experienced war in which innocent gets killed. But he never forgets Madame Marcel Cunegonde. When he reached Holland, he optimistically believed that he would be well treated, as he once had been in Westphalia, for were not the Hollanders Christian. So the belief that Hollanders will treat him because they are Catholic, but he doesn't get anything. So the Christian charity and other things don't work practically. So again, this is a pessimistic attitude that he develops. He understands that the world as such is not that good. But even when he started begging, one native threatened him, saying that he will be arrested for begging alms and he'll be put in prison. Now, it was an Anabaptist, or a person who has not been completely baptized, a man to play the role of the Good Samaritan. So his generosity and kindness reaffirmed in candid faith in the belief that of Dr. Pangloss. So Anabaptist saves him, gives him food and everything, and now he understands that what Dr. Pangloss said is right. This world is not a bad world. This is a good world. Even though some bad things happen, still this world is a good world. Now we find the candid meeting, coming across a beggar covered with all kinds of sores, and the beggar's eyes were lifeless and the tip of his nose had been eaten away by disease. His mouth was twisted and he was racked by a violent cough. He spat out a tooth with every spasm. So he is in a terrible condition. So who is this beggar? So it so happens that the deceased and the really pathetic beggar happens to be none other than the Dr. Pangloss, who taught them the philosophy that this world is the best world. So now he is in a bitter condition. Now he is a beggar, pathetic and deceased and really in a bad condition. So Candid wanted to ask him, oh, so this is the best of the best world. So where are you now? Look, this, you say that this the philosophy that this is the best world, but still you are now a beggar. And now we understand what happened to the Baron Cunegonde and others. So the army attacked, the Bulgarian army attacked the fort immediately after Candid was thrown out, and the Baron was killed, his wife was killed, everybody was killed, Cunegonde was raped, and many things happened. So Candid soon... So now looking at what happened to all those people whom he liked. So now he understands that. Now he understands how Pangloss had got this illness, because the chamber lady with whom he had a relationship, Packut, the pretty attendant of the Baroness, with whom he had engaged in experimental physics, which later led to the Cunegonde doing it with Candid, and which ultimately led to all his misery. So this Packet had a sexually transmitted illness. So, and this was spread to Pangloss because of his experimental physics relationship with her. And now this has actually come from Columbus. So this illness was spread from US, America. So they got it from America, and Columbus was the person who brought it to Europe. But now Pangloss says that if Columbus had not discovered America, they would not have eaten chocolate and cochineal and other things which are really good, coffee and chocolate. So that is something good. So anyway, we can't blame Columbus for bringing syphilis to Europe, because that is the illness that Pangloss has. So syphilis, Columbus cannot be blamed for bringing syphilis to Europe, because he has also brought something sweet and other things like chocolate and other things to Europe. So we can completely blame him for this. We find that the Anabaptist who had earlier rescued Candide also helps Pangloss. So Pangloss is now given treatment and he gets cured, but he lost the sight, eyesight of one eye, and also the capability of hearing of one ear. But still, he is very optimistic. Pangloss is still optimistic, and he joins the Anabaptist as a bookkeeper. And so together, all of them travel to Lisbon. Now Pangloss is talking, expounding his philosophy to his benefactor, the Anabaptist. But the latter, Anabaptist, still remains unconvinced that men are not actually good. So that is there, but when they are not born wolves, they have become wolves and sought to destroy each other. So even though, and the Anabaptist's theory is that men are actually basically good, but they become wolves because of greed and other things. Now we find that the ship is when which they are traveling is shaken up because of a huge big tempest that is there, and now it is sailing out of the sight of port of Lisbon. So the ship is in a dangerous position now, and the crew and the passengers are all frightened what is going to happen. They don't know what is going to happen, so they are tossed helplessly here and there. Then one of the so now we find that the Anabaptist is struck a hard blow, and from the force of it, the sailor himself fell overboard. So so now we find the sailor who hits the Anabaptist falls overboard, and caught on the masthead, he seemed to be lost. But only the good Anabaptist jumps out into the sea and tries to save him and rescued him, lost his life, and he brings him. Now Candide wants to jump into the sea and to save the Anabaptist, but Pangloss says that no, don't jump, because providence or fate had arranged all this so that the Anabaptist would not survive. So it is fate that decides things, and the Anabaptist died because of fate. For the doctor, all things continue to be for the best, and the moment the ship splits open, everyone perishes except Candide, Pangloss, and the sailor who had been saved by the Anabaptist but who refused to save the Anabaptist. So the two good people and one evil person, they all escape. So what happened in the ship is that the ship is caught by a tempest, and sailors are thrown overboard. Anabaptist goes out to save one sailor, but he doesn't return the favor, so Anabaptist dies. Candide wants to save the Anabaptist, but the Dr. Pangloss prevents him, saying that it is his fate to die, so we have to trust in the fate. So that is what happens, and finally everybody gets destroyed. The ship gets destroyed, and everybody is thrown overboard, and only three people are saved. One is the Anabaptist, not one is a sailor who was saved by the Anabaptist, then the Pangloss and Candide. So three, they come to the shore. Now immediately they come, there is a big earthquake going on. They witness an earthquake that lasted 6 minutes and destroyed everything. And when the other two try to save the people, and the sailor, he goes around looking for money, and he gets hold of alcohol and get drunks, and he flirts with women and all kinds of bad things he's engaged in. And now this is really pathetic. While the other two are trying to help, this fellow is going around enjoying. Now the two are in search for food, and they get some food, and they try to help the people. And Pangloss is always there giving comfort to people and saying that whatever happens is good, whatever happens is good. There's nothing bad in this earthquake, there's nothing bad. Suddenly he's challenged by somebody saying that this Pangloss is spreading messages that are against religion and says that there is something called original sin, and this is punishment for sin of what man did, man's disobedience to God. This is a sin for that, and you are trying to say, you are trying to spread the message that this is the great world and other things. So no, you are absolutely wrong, and you are spreading the wrong message. So they try to do all these things. They try to help the people. Now, because of spreading the false news, Pangloss is arrested. And for candid, for listening to the message that is given by Pangloss, he is also arrested. Both are to be killed. So Pangloss is going to be hanged, and Candid will be flogged. In time to the music, the Biscan was burned at the stake. So now what happened is that everybody who got involved with Pangloss and Candid, they are punished. So Candid is flogged and Pangloss gets hanged. So Pangloss is dead now. But now there is another terrible earthquake that occurs. On now, Candid analysis what happened to him, all the experience that he had, and he understands that still the world is, as per Pangloss's teaching, he was only flogged and he did not die, so he is still living, so still he has some optimism left.